All right, I've been waiting for some consolidation in the oil industry. There are simply too many independent operators out there, real good ones, by the way. And the stocks are so cheap that I figured some deal has to be inevitable. Finally, on Friday, we got the big one. Chevron told us that it's buying Anadarko Petroleum, a holding of my charitable trust, which is a major exploration production company, for $33 billion. I think it's a very smart deal. It's a game changer. Do not take it from me. Let's get a closer look with Mike Wirth, the chairman and CEO of Chevron, who's taking some time during a very busy period to tell us about this Anadarko acquisition. Mr. Wirth, welcome to Mad Money. Good to see you, sir. Have a seat.
Good to see you.
All right. Thank you, Mike. I have long loved Anadarko, even from the days of Mr. Hackett, because I always thought they had unbelievable properties. I was shocked that it never recovered, even from when they won the Colorado ballot, for heaven's sake. How come it was so cheap? And how did you know that it was the right time to go?
Well, I'm not sure I can tell you exactly why it was the right time and why they have traded the way they have. They're a very good company.
Yeah.
They've done a nice job high-grading their portfolio. They've got good management, and we like everything about it. It's a good company, good assets, good people, and a good deal.
And you're now number one in the best area, maybe in the country, if not the world.
In the Permian Basin?
Yes.
We really like our position in the Permian. We like it even better now that we've been able to combine with Anadarko's. And it is a great resource for our country and a great one for our company.
Some people have been telling me that, look, the Permian's almost tapped out. Others have told me, are you kidding? With the new techniques we have, the new science we have, there's years to play.
Years or decades.
Decades.
We have, we're right now drilling hundreds of wells. We see thousands and thousands of well locations and multiple benches that we'll be able to drill. And the technology does continue to get better. The practices get better. And we see a lot of running room in the Permian.
Before I turn to Permian, international has always been your specialty with Gulf of Mexico, but you're all over the world. This Mozambique facility, I love it, but there are insurgents there. There is worry. How can you make it so that that's safe? Because that is one of the great, you're getting a gift.
Well, it's a beautiful gas resource, and we've operated in Africa for 100 years. So we're not unfamiliar with some of the challenges that go with working in that part of the world. We've been in Nigeria, we've been in Angola, Republic of Congo, South Africa. So we know Africa, we know the precautions that we need to take to keep our people safe and our operations safe. And Anadarko's done a really nice job developing this project, and we are highly supportive of their advancing it here prior to the close of the merger, and we look forward to a very successful project.
Now, you were able to get this. Some people are saying, look, I mean, my colleague David Faber said there was a mid-70s bid by Occidental. You can't tell me why Anadarko chose you, because they chose you. You didn't. But your offer was one that they seemed to think was more compelling than another offer that was higher priced. Why did they like Chevron, if you could give me any hint at all about why?
Well, I can't really speak on behalf of their board. I can tell you that we put together what we think is a full and compelling offer. There's a beautiful strategic fit between our two companies. We've got a very complementary position in the Permian, in the deep water, Mozambique. There are people. It's baseball season, Jim. It's a grand slam. Permian Basin, deep water Gulf of Mexico, Mozambique, people. It's a grand slam.
It doesn't get any better than that. How contiguous you are. I mean, it's rather amazing how contiguous you are in Permian.
We've got about 75 miles where we've got a very contiguous, blocked-up area that we can develop it with great efficiency and create real value for the shareholders of both companies.
Now, I was surprised to hear you're talking about maybe shedding $20 billion of assets. I mean, do you really have that much that you're willing to sell?
We've got a global portfolio, and we've got a lot of value in really good assets from Chevron, really good assets that will come in from Anadarko.
Right.
And we're going to operate in a disciplined capital regime.
Okay.
And we won't be able to fund everything that we have. What we've learned is there are projects that meet our economic thresholds, but they're not as strong as others in our inventory. And oftentimes, those projects are a better fit for someone else. So we'll move assets out that are not the strongest assets in our portfolio that might be very good for others to operate and invest in.
Did you know that Occidental was on the verge of making a bid the same day?
You know, we didn't know anything other than our negotiations
and
discussions with Anadarko.
Were you surprised subsequent to know that Vicky Hobb was about to make a move?
You know, I can't comment on that. I'll say we've made a full and compelling offer. It's a certain offer, and we intend to close.
Okay, now, Pascagoula, that is a gigantic, third largest U.S. processor of heavy sulfur, Venezuelan crude. Now, it looks like Venezuelan crude is not coming. So what will you do with that facility?
Well, you can run a variety of crudes.
But not yours from Permian because it's light sweet.
It's light sweet. So that's one of the challenges with all the light oil coming out of the U.S. is more of it will be exported. The U.S. refining system is built to run different grades. But those grades are available in the world, and we're pretty efficient at optimizing feedstocks with shipping into refineries around the world to create value.
One last question. Anadarko's last quarter was not up to snuff, according to the stock market. I thought it was okay. Had a lot, you know, had some natural gas, had some little mishaps. But that ultimately did create the ultimate value. Was there anything about that quarter that gave you any sort of trepidation about this?
No, we look through any quarterly or transient kinds of effects. This is a long-term business.
Well, I want people to listen to that. See, because this is what happens. They have one bad quarter. You and I both know that's a great company. I was in shock that it was hit so hard, given their reputation, how good they are, how good their properties are. That was a fabulous opportunity for you.
It's a long-term business. They've got great assets, great people. We're really looking forward to bringing these together and creating value for the shareholders.
Well, I want to congratulate you. I thought it was great. And you upped the buyback the same day you did it. That is just fantastic. That's Mike Wirth, Chairman and CEO of Chevron. They bought one of my longtime favorites, Anadarko, and I think it's going to be great for them. Mad Money's back after the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.